third type, if I remove this chlorine and add phenyl group like this one, CH2 double bond CH, and here we have the benzene ring. So polymerization of this gives, the name of this compound is styrene, and the polymerization of this gives what?
Polystyrene.
Okay, the use of this is, I am not drawing the structure here again, but can you tell me what is the repeating unit of this?
CH2 single bond CH
phenyl ring and open bond both sides, N, correct? Like that you can draw the structure. So I'm not drawing it here again because we know how to draw this. Another example, you see, we remove this benzene ring and we attach CN here, cyanide. This molecule, we call it as acrylonitrile, A-C-R-Y-O nitrile. And on polymerization, this gives what? Polyacrylonitrile. All these are homopolymers. This, we also call it as orlone. The name of polyacrylonitrile, the general name is orlone, O-R-L-O-N. Polyacrylonitrile we use for the formation of fibers. Uses. Fifth one, if I remove all the hydrogen atom and add fluorine, CF2 double bond CF2, polymerization. This compound is tetrafluoro tetrafluoroethylene is the monomer, and polymerization of this gives you the compound which we call it as Teflon. And the Teflon, that use of this is the formation of non-copeware.
Even mouse feet is made of Teflon.
Yes. Clear?
Yes, sir.
So these 4 or 5 examples you must remember. All these are examples of homopolymer, not copolymer. Okay? Yeah. Now the next thing is, what are the polymerization technique we have? That is reaction. What reactions involve in polymerization? Write down the reaction involved in just a second. Acrylonitrile vulcanization. Okay, so two types of polymerization reaction we have. So heading is polymerization reaction. Like I said, two types of polymerization reaction we have. The first one is addition polymerization. Addition polymerization. Leave some space here. And the second one you write down, condensation polymerization. Condensation polymerization. Addition polymerization, also we have three types in it. The first one is free radical polymerization. The second one is cationic polymerization. Polymerization. And the third one is anionic polymerization. Got it?
Yeah.
Condensation polymerization, what happens into this? The molecules like water, NH3, HCl, etc., goes out, eliminates, okay? And the two molecules combine. Okay, so these are the two types of reaction we have. First of all, we'll see free radical polymerization. So next heading you write down, free radical, because cationic and anionic, we'll not go into that detail. I'll just give you the idea how it forms. Basically, the difference in these three reactions is what? The intermediate are free radical, cation, anion. That is the only difference. Okay, so reaction part is not that important, but free radical, we'll see that. Write down the first one, free radical polymerization. Free radical polymerization. See, free radical polymerization, this mechanism involves the formation of free radical. Okay? And that's why this, we also call it as chain growth polymerization. Because in free radical mechanism, we know there is initiation step, then chain propagation, then chain termination. So this we also call it as chain growth polymerization. Chain growth polymerization. And since free radical involves in this, so these kind of reaction is very difficult to stop. Difficult to stop means we do not have any control on this reaction. Okay, so that's why we most probably will get a very complex structure into it. If you try to control it, it's not possible, because the intermediate is free radical, which is highly reactive, and we know in free radical reactions we do not have any control into that. Okay, that is one thing. Now for this reaction, since it involves free radical, so this reaction actually requires a free radical agent, okay, which forms free radical generally. So for this reaction we need a free radical agent. Free radical agent are those molecules or compounds which helps in the formation of free radical. Okay, It helps in the formation of free radical. Like, for example, we can take any peroxide or oxygen. O2 as a catalyst we can take, or we can take any peroxide for this purpose. In general, we use benzoyl peroxide. As free radical agent. So benzoyl peroxide, if you look at the structure of benzoyl peroxide is this pH, C double bond O, and then we have a peroxide linkage, C double bond O and pH. Okay. So what happens with this benzoyl peroxide? All these peroxy compounds where we have this linkage, peroxy linkage, are generally not that stable. And when you heat this slightly, this bond dissociates and it forms a radical, which is pH, C double bond O, O radical plus pH, C double bond O, O radical. Why this happens? Because these two oxygen has lone pair of electron on it, and that's why we have very high lone pair repulsion. And hence, the dissociation of this bond is easier. Okay. So one of the electron here is taken up by this oxygen and another one is taken up by this oxygen. Okay. And it forms a free radical like this. We also know that this free radical has property to eliminate neutral molecule. Neutral molecule and forms new free radical. So in this, what happens? Two CO2 molecule eliminates. I'm writing down for both one. One CO2 from this, one CO2 from this eliminate. And we'll get two phenyl radical. I should write down this. We'll get two phenyl radical. Got it?
Got it. Yes, sir.
So this is the first step of the reaction. And this step, like I said, we call it as chain initiation step. Free radical mechanism, chain initiation step. Okay. Next step is what? Chain propagation. So in chain propagation, what happens? This phenyl radical in the next step, this phenyl radical has the one free radical here. It reacts with the ethylene that you have and with a suitable pressure temperature catalyst. So here this one electron comes over here, one electron comes over here, and these two joins like this. So the product is this. CH single bond CH2 radical. Okay. Like this only, the chain propagates. Okay. We have another molecule also. CH2 double bond CH2 combines with this here and we'll get a long chain. So in short, if I write down n times if this steps goes, then it gives pH CH2 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 radical. This is suppose n times. Like this compound will get CH2 radical. Okay. And finally, what happens? This one and this one club together because we have this kind of many compounds are there. So all these clubs together and it forms pH CH2 CH2 pH the whole thing. Suppose this is X number of times. Like this only. Okay. And finally, this pH goes out and we'll get a long chain compound here. So basically, this reaction involves, so this last step is chain termination. When all the free radical combines together, this step is chain termination. From here to here, it is chain propagation. And till here, it is chain initiation. Okay. So like you see, free radical involves in this reaction. So the structure of the polymer that you get here is very complex. There is no proper arrangement, order arrangement here. Why? Because the intermediate is free radical, which is highly reactive, and we do not have any control in such reaction. Copy it down.
So heating unit is just CH2, right? Both the
yes. Monomer is that only, no? CH2 double bond CH2. So with that only we'll get the repeating unit. For homopolymers, the repeating unit is not that important. For copolymer, it is important. We'll see that also. Okay. So similarly, we have cationic polymerization. There, the intermediate is in cation. Okay. Anionic polymerization, intermediate is in anion. Okay. So that mechanism, like I said, this is also not important. The only thing is, if you have any cation, suppose H+ present, then this CH2 double bond CH2 will attack like this. If I write down here, you see. CH2 double bond CH2 we have with H+, it forms CH3 CH2+. Now this reacts with again CH2 double bond CH2 and the reaction proceeds. Okay, so that's how the reaction goes in cationic polymerization. Anionic may will have this. If you have suppose a salt like KNH2. So it is K+ NH2-. And when this reacts with CH2 double bond CH2, so in this, what happens? This minus attacks onto this carbon and this goes here. So we'll get CH2, NH2, NH2, CH2, and CH2 negative. So this is cationic polymerization, this is anionic polymerization. Again, this negative charge will attack onto this molecule, shift, and we get a long chain compound. That's how it goes. So like I said, it is not important. Okay, the mechanism here. Okay. This is the three reaction we have. Addition and addition polymerization, which involves free radical, cationic polymerization, and anionic polymerization.